and gentlemen, you are very welcome to the Sundays at Noon concert series, filmed here in the Hugh Lane Gallery Sculpture Hall. We are delighted to welcome Mia Cooper, Nick Roth, Dermot Dunne and Malachy Robinson to perform here today. Before we begin today's concert, I would like to thank the Arts Council of Ireland, NearFM TV and the staff of the Hugh Lane Gallery for their continued support. Thank you for joining us today and enjoy the concert.
Thank you. joined by Dermot Dunne, accordionist, and Nick Roth, saxophonist. You're very welcome to the Hugh Lane Gallery.
Thank you.
Thank
you. Dermot, when you were growing up, was there music in your family? What kind of influences were there to sow the seeds, so to speak?
Oh, okay. Yeah, there was a lot of music, but it was mostly records, you know, on the turntable. So it was, my brothers had very eclectic tastes, you know, Bob Dylan, of course, the Beatles, ELO, a little bit of Beethoven and Bach as well. And then there was ABBA and Blondie from my sisters. So those were my early influences.
What led you to the accordion?
Well, two things. First of all, one day when I was in third class, a girl was brought from class to class. She had an accordion to play Scott Joplin's Entertainer. I thought, wow, like that was just like she was playing the melody on the right hand and the bass and the chords on the left hand. And we had one at home, locked away in the closet. So where you're going to say it should have stayed. So I dragged it out and I had no clue how to like strap it on. It's like, so I'd lay it down on the bed and kind of play it like, you know, a piano. And not that I could play the piano either. And eventually it just kind of snowballed from there.
Nick, you're the saxophonist in today's performance. What kind of influences did you have as a child in terms of getting into music?
Yeah, my story is quite simple, really. My mom is a music teacher and she still runs a big band, like a jazz big band called Badge. So when I was a baby, it was every Tuesday night and I'd be in a cot in the corner. And then when I was a toddler, I'd be running around. And then I joined the band when I was 9, I think, on saxophone. And yeah, that was the influence. And then I've never looked back or forward.
What inspired you, Nick, to then say, I'm going to make a career out of this, I'm going to become a professional musician?
Yeah, that's a good question. So my dad did a deal with me when I moved to Dublin, and he said, for every punt that you earn, I'll give you an extra one. Actually, the night before moving to Dublin, I met the Trinity Jazz Society crowd at a party in London, and they needed a saxophone player. So when I moved over, I had a weekly gig in Gubu. There was 50 punt a week. And then a few weeks in, went to the Cork Jazz Festival with a guitarist I'd met called Dan Jacobson. And we were playing in the street at the Jazz Festival. This guy called Tony Holohan came up and said, congratulations, you've won the busking competition. Can you stay here for a minute? And we'll be back in half an hour. And they came back in half an hour and they had a check from Western Union. It was this size and we had to stand in front of it. We're like, what is going on? And we won 500 punt. So I called my dad and I was like, okay, so we've got a weekly gig for 50 and you know, we've just won this thing. And he was like, you're on your own. Yeah, that was it.
Dermot, who were your early influences in terms of inspiring you in terms of accordion music?
Yeah, my first accordion teacher was actually a local teacher, Paddy Kavanagh, great accordion teacher. And he had a huge school. He had like 4 accordion orchestras. So like there were about 20 in each orchestra. There was the beginners, the junior, the intern, the senior. And so I was really wanting to get to the senior orchestra. And they played a great selection of tunes, hits from musicals, the Barber of Seville Overture, Brahms' Hungarian Dance, that kind of stuff. And there was a bit of classical thrown in, and that kind of became more and more as time went on.
Today's concert, Dermot, tell me a little bit about the music, because it's from the late 19th century.
Yeah, and early 20th. So there are two pieces, Pictures at an Exhibition by Mussorgsky. And this is a piece that was on for the Leaving Cert, when I did the Leaving Cert, one of the set pieces you had to study. So I've known it since then, and I always loved the piece. In fact, I played it as a solo piece here in the gallery about 10 years ago. It was a lot of work as a solo piece, so it's much nicer when you could divvy out the job. And then the other piece is by a Hungarian, Zoltán Kodály, and it's a collection of folk tunes from a town where he went as a kid. And it's actually the very first piece I ever heard an orchestra playing when I was about 12 or 13, live, you know, in the National Concert Hall. And it made a huge impression on me. It was just like so exciting. And I just really wanted to play it, and there's no part for the accordion in the orchestra, so I'm going to have to put my own band together, you know, play this tune, and there you go.
And the instrument that you're playing, a Piccini button accordion, tell us about that instrument.
Right, well, I'm not going to get very technical, but there are a lot of different shapes and sizes and ways, you know, the instruments. Like, it's not like a violin. They all have the same construction and same four strings. So accordions come in, you know, a big range. And I've had started with a small one, then bigger, bigger over the years. So this one, most people are surprised to hear that it has the same range of a grand piano or an upright piano from the lowest E and right up to the highest note and even one note higher, C sharp, that the piano doesn't have. So it has that range on both sides. So you can play something like Pictures at an Exhibition as a solo piece.
Nick, you're not just a performer as well, but you're also a composer and educator. What about your own studies on the saxophone? I'd imagine quite a few years of work.
Yeah, I mean, I'm kind of still learning, really. I mean, it's a constant journey and learning. I write a lot of music as well. I wrote a piece for Dermot. It's an accordion quintet, so accordion and a string quartet. And working on a solo cello piece at the moment for Kate Ellis.
I know you're very much into the idea of no boundaries, in a sense, in music. Is that how you write?
Yeah, I mean, music is music. I also run a record label called Diatribe with Matthew Jacobson, and our kind of you know, raison d'etre or modus operandi was always just like, just record good music. Like, if it's good, it's good. And it's basically notes and rhythms, right? I mean, that's what all music is. So I like to get past the idea of particular genres and labels and, you know, sticking words on music and just allow the music to speak for itself. And, you know, I think when you look at it like that, you find that any kind of music from anywhere in the world shares a lot more in common with music than there are differences. Yeah.
And are there composers and musicians who continue to inspire you today?
Oh yeah, I mean, millions. These musicians continue to inspire me. And yeah, I mean, I'm constantly hearing new things and going back and finding music from, you know, the 11th century or the 12th century. Today I was looking earlier at the Couperin preludes, you know, which is music from, when's Couperin, 17th century, 1600s?
Yeah, yeah.
And it's this incredible kind of almost graphic notation where the notes are kind of written with like lines across the page, and, you know, suddenly like you realize that somebody writing music 400 years ago could easily sit in and do this gig this afternoon. You know, like, it's those kind of, that boundaryless state exists not just across space but also across time.
Dermot Dunne and Nick Roth, thank you very much indeed.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us. I hope you enjoy the music. Mm-hmm.